YouTube, Mike Swingman here giving you guys another video. In today's video, we are going to go over the best hitting approach when it comes to same pitching side, hitting approach. Okay, I know it sounds a little weird, but you know what? We're going to dive into it because it's very important, especially in something that you can look for in the show 21, all right? But before we dive into that video, I want you guys to go ahead and smash that subscribe button, hit those bell notification buttons so that you guys are also notified for my future uploads on this channel, all right? We're on the road to 500 subscribers. Currently, as I'm recording this video right now, we're at 458. So I'd really appreciate it if you guys can do that and so forth. But with that being said, let's go ahead and dive into the video. All right, guys. So little quick video for today. And this is we're going to talk about basically the same side hitting approach in the show 21 and what I use and what you will have to expect when it comes to what your pitcher is going to throw to you. When it comes to like a right-handed pitcher versus a right-handed batter and vice versa when it comes to lefties. Okay. But what I've really noticed, okay, and my hitting approach basically never changes. You know, obviously we're going to look a lot of inside pitches than outside, okay? Because more likely than not, your opponent is going to attack you inside. They're going to battle you inside. They're going to have you prove to them that, for one, you can turn on that heater or even sit on a breaking ball inside, okay? But what I really noticed about the breaks of what you'll see, okay, usually the drop pitches, or what I call the vertical breaks, are going to be more on the inner portion of the zone, and then the horizontal or the across breaks will be on the outer portion of the zone. Okay, so what do I mean by that? Okay, so you're going to see more like curveballs, changeups, and maybe, you know, more like fastballs. Well, obviously you're going to see that on the inside portion of the zone when you're righty on righty or lefty on lefty. Now, when it comes to the horizontal breaks, that's more of the cutters slash sliders that will go to the outer part of the zone. Reason why is it's really hard to time those pitches up because when it comes out of the hand, it looks like a fastball and then it cuts across. Okay, because the first instinct that us hitters have is, as soon as we see that inside pitch, we got to react and press X and just turn on it. Okay, so that's why most guys, they'll go with their cross pitch, because it will make you out in front, roll over, and probably hit a ground ball, just like in real life, right? Okay, so the approach that I recommend you do, okay, and what I do, I usually place my PCI on the top portion of the zone, just in the top, very, just a little bit, and I work on just going from in or out, okay? Because if he misses up in the middle, well then, hey, my PCI is in the middle, I can just wait on it and go yard, okay? But what I really notice, okay, is that I am only looking for two windows, okay? You're either going to see the ball go high and in or middle away. You're going to either see it that way, okay? You cannot control if it goes low and away perfectly on that corner. You can't control that. But what you can control, because he will give you that pitch, is that he or she are gonna find a way to throw a strike. Okay, because if they're throwing balls, I promise you they're not gonna throw it down the middle. It's not gonna happen. Okay, more likely not gonna happen. They're gonna try to dot you. Okay, and the beauty about, you know, hitting in this game with pinpoint pitching is that you can now place that PCI where he might dot it. Okay, that's the beauty about hitting home runs in this game. But even though the timing window is messed up, but my thing to you is this, okay? You're going to see the drop vertical pitches on the inside portion, and you're going to see the horizontal breaks on the outside portion, okay? So sliders, cutters away, 12-6 curveballs, changeups, and fastballs inside, okay? This is something that I have noticed, and I hope it helps you guys. That is the approach, really, and that's the thing that you can expect when facing a righty-righty or a lefty-lefty. All right, guys, that is it for today's video. We talked about what to expect when it comes to the same side hitting and pitching and what approach to use. This is something that I have gotten a lot of questions during my Twitch streams, you know, which, by the way, I recommend you guys go ahead and follow my Twitch. I do stream during the week, other than maybe Wednesdays and Sundays. We do in the morning, so I highly recommend you guys go check it out if you guys have any questions. But also, it is something that I have noticed, you know, just playing the game on Legend. And I think this is something that I cracked into and I figured it out. So I want to help the community the best way I can. And not only that, when you kind of have an understanding of how they're pitching, now you know how to pitch to your opponent. And you know what your opponent is looking for. Okay? All right. So if you guys love the video or like this video, be sure to hit that like button. Also comment in the comment sections below on what your approach is on the same side hitting and pitching. All right. And also comment on what of how this approach helped you in the show 21. Okay. I want you guys to also hit that subscribe button and bell notifications button so that you guys are notified for the future uploads on this channel. I wish you guys nothing but pinpoint pitching and perfect perfects. And I, Swingman, will see you guys in the next one. Take care.